I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Winter Haven. I'm Gabby, and you're watching BDTV for Tuesday, February 20, 2024. February is Black History Month. This month, we'll be celebrating by announcing an important figure on BDTV every day. We'll also be including some Black history facts about some of our campus staff. Today, we'll be highlighting Barack Obama. Barack Obama is an American politician who served as the 44th President of the United States from 2009 to 2017. A member of the Democratic Party, he was the first African-American president in the U.S. history. Did you know that Assistant Principal Jennings, Ms. Phillips, Coach Haggins, Ms. Douglas Haggins, and LTC Reeves are all a part of the National Pan-Hellenic Greek Fraternities or Sororities? Coming up on today's show is Teen Court and National Food Snack Day. For this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. M&M's, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang. For this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. M&M's, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang. Pop it, pop it. Drop the top, play hide and seek. Jump inside, jump straight to the lid. Take a sip. I'm Nico.
And I'm Sadie.
Let's get into the announcements.
Students, remember to check your email every day. You may receive important school news through your school email.
The new scholarship bulletin for February is out now. Check these out in our guidance or on our school's website.
There are volunteer opportunities on the Guidance Department's Community Service Bulletin Board. Check these out for community service hours.
Do you want to do what we're doing right now? If you like filming, editing, connecting with the student body, and creating lifetime friendships, you should join BDTV. You must be a junior or a senior and have taken broadcast journalism for at least 1 year. Stop by Ms. Mizell in room 36107 for an application. An application is required to be even considered.
Prom guest applications are available in the cafeteria during all four lunches. They are due no later than February 29th. The guest ID must be attached and the application must be signed by an administrator from Winter Haven and the guest's last school attended. All guests must be at least 14 years old and no older than 20 years old on April 12, 2024. Guests are any persons who are not currently a Winter Haven junior or a senior student. All attendees must have a picture ID to be admitted.
All student drivers must purchase and display a parking permit. The cage is strictly for OJT and no credit study hall students. Let's go to Interior for more information.
When driving to school, it's important that you adhere to all of the rules that are set. I'm Interior with BDTV, and here's a couple of reminders for student drivers. All student drivers are required to purchase and display a parking permit. The cage is strictly for OJT and no credit study hall. All others are required to park in the north parking lot. Drivers will be given a $10 ticket every time they are caught, and it will be added to their obligations. Please note that even if you do not have a permit and you park on campus, your tag can still be ran and you will be fined. I'm Ateria with BDTV, and don't forget these reminders, Winter Haven.
I'm glad I have my parking pass.
Congratulations to one of our own aerospace students, Emmanuel Ibar, on achieving his first solo flight. This is a really big deal for an aspiring pilot because it's the first time you are ever in the plane by yourself. It is a life-changing experience for many. Emmanuel, who is a senior, plans to use the James C. Ray Scholarship to earn his private pilot's license before he graduates so that he can move on to the military to serve for our country. Be sure to congratulate Emmanuel if you see him.
Winter Haven High School has two students, J.P. Phillips and Quania Gray DeSanders, this week's lecture, Tremendous 10. Vote early and often. Use this QR code to vote.
Ridge Technical College is having a career fair from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. and open house from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Thursday, April 11th. Ridge has over 20 programs available, industry certifications, and professional training in America's fastest growing careers.
Academy Day, hosted by the Office of Congressman Scott Franklin, is scheduled for February 24th from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. at Polk State College Center for Public Safety Auditorium. Lee, a zone officials from each of the service academies will discuss the application process, academy requirements, and congressional nominations.
Hey Sadie, have you ever gone to Teen Court?
You may know by now that Teen Court provides numerous benefits to the community, but did you know that it benefits the volunteers as well? This comes in the form of service hours, new career connections, and maybe a new interest in law. I'm Colin with BDTV. Let's go learn a little bit more about Teen Court. Why did you join Teen Court?
I joined Teen Court because I needed some more community service hours because I didn't have that many. And I joined because I wanted to learn more about the legal system because law might be like something I'm interested in for the future. And a couple of my friends didn't, and I thought it would be like a good way to hang out with them outside of school while doing something like good for community service and stuff like that.
Teen Court is held every Monday night with sessions beginning at 6 p.m. As a volunteer, you have two options. You can serve as a juror, where you hear cases and decide on punishment, ranging from service hours to jury duties to online classes. This is for two service hours. The other option is to serve as a teen attorney. You can either represent the state as prosecution or your peers as defense counsel. This is for four service hours. What skills have you developed through your involvement with Teen Court?
Well, in Teen Court, you start to pick up a lot of communication skills with lots of various people. You meet a lot of new people, and you have to start learning their body language and how to communicate with them. And there's a lot of things you need to start picking up on, depending on what you can. And you'll start to get better at public speaking and all sorts of things like that, because you still have to talk to a lot of people, and sometimes it's to crowds of people or small groups. So from there, you could talk to all of the defendants.
Teen Court takes place in the Polk County Courthouse in Bartow. They're always looking for some new volunteers. I'm Colin with the BDTV. I'll see you in Court, Winter Haven.
Thanks, Colin, for that info on Teen Court.
Interested in print journalism, photography, or just like to write? Any student interested in joining the staff of the school's newspaper, The Trident, may pick up an application from Ms. Shubley in room 35224. You must complete an application and turn it in to even be considered for this class.
This group had an amazing time at the museum. What a great way to enjoy art with a field trip to the art museum.
Congratulations to the following students who placed first, second, and third in the DECA district competition and qualified to compete at the state level. Kamari Aaron, Principals of Marketing, Sophie Bose and Sherlyn Murillo, Integrated Marketing Campaign Event, Tina Chow and Rihanna Islam, Hospitality Services and Decision Making, Rose Joseph, Personal Finance, Jasleen DeLeon, Food Marketing, Amelia Jump and Cecilia Roberts, Sports and Entertaining Marketing Decision Making, Ricardo Murillo, Quick Serve Restaurant Management, Brian Rivas and Ana Marie Ruiz Perea for Entrepreneurship Team Decision Making.
Winter Haven High School will hold a career fair in the gym on March 6th from 10 a.m. until 12:30. These will be for seniors and juniors only.
Polk State College will have representatives on campus again next Wednesday, February 21st, from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. in the Guidance Lab. Polk State College scholarship applications are open until February 28th. If you have applied for the Polk Education Foundation Scholarship and are heading to Polk State, you may apply for both of these foundation scholarships.
Let's go to Faith to learn more about National Snack Food Day.
The month of February is nationally known for Valentine's Day, but did you know this is also National Snack Food Month? This month focuses on snacking in the most healthiest ways possible. I'm Faith of BDTV. Let's go see how our students are snacking this month. What's your favorite snack?
Street tacos.
Cheeseburgers.
Oreos.
Sneakers.
Clearly, you can see our students' favorite snacks are definitely not the healthiest. Let's go see if we can fix this. What are some ways our students can become more nutritious, especially when it comes to snacking?
It's always a lot easier to go to McDonald's or Taco Bell or something, but it really doesn't take a lot of effort to eat healthier. You can make pico de gallo, which is like a good fresh salsa with tomatoes and onions and cilantro and stuff. It's fun to make, tastes really good. It's a whole lot healthier too.
Why is it important for you to eat a nutritious snack?
Because I play sports like outside of school, like baseball, and it really helps me to keep my momentum going, like with energy.
What's your favorite healthy snack?
My favorite healthy snack is probably Clif Bars because they gave me a lot of energy for lacrosse practice since we go 5 days a week. And then the protein is always good to build up muscle since we're in the weight room a lot and we're always out practicing.
Now since we have learned some great tips on how to be healthier, let's go see if we change some of our students' minds on their favorite snacks. What's your favorite snack?
Acai bowls.
Cheese.
Strawberries.
Bananas.
Clearly, our students have learned some new and fun ways on how to snack healthier. By choosing to eat healthy and nutritious snacks, you're not only benefiting yourself, but also your stomach. I'm Faith with BDTV. Go get yourself a snack, Winter Haven.
Thanks, Faith, for all the information on National Snack Food Day. Are you interested in taking pictures for the yearbook or even editing the yearbook? See Ms. Jaime for an application in her room. Our Winter Haven FFA is having a barbecue fundraiser. The cost is $13. It'll be held on Wednesday, February 28th. You have a choice of shredded pork or half chicken. It also comes with barbecue beans, coleslaw, and a dinner roll. Pickup is between 5 and 7 p.m. There will be another Fast Food workshop on Thursday, February 22nd at 6 p.m. in the Media Center. You must have your FAFSA ID created and your parent must have theirs created as well before coming to the workshop. See Ms. Bachman if you have any questions. That's all we have for you today, Warner Haven. I'm Bradley with BDTV. Have a great day and stay tuned for Rally.
I'm sure you remember me from the last time I was here to talk about Rally. And I'm here to talk about it again with you. Rally is a Christian-based organization that really focuses on spreading an encouraging message to students. Rally is every Wednesday after school in room 35206. We hang out, we play games, and after all of that, we listen to a short encouraging message. It is from 2 to 2:30, and I hope you come out and listen to a great message. See you there.